Okay, this is my avocado update, long overdue. I meant to do this during the summertime, but just got busy with other things. But basically, these are the little cages that I built. Planter boxes, this is kind of what they look like. And we're in December now, about mid-December. And I wanted to do this because the next step I have to do is get them ready for the frost, which I'm gonna do a plastic wrap and stuff. But this was the summertime, lots of air. And the wire mesh is because we have a mongrel in the backyard you'll see pretty soon. But this one is the lamb hoss, and it survived, and it's not really growing too much, but it's doing okay. This one back here was my surprise, but surprise was just dying back there. It was, you know, just dying a little bit more each day. So that is an actual hoss, true hoss from Lowe's or something. I threw it in. And it seems to be doing a little bit better back there. It's kind of dark, so I didn't bother shade wrapping that one. And I dug up the surprise trying to save it because it was heading downhill fast. And I pulled it out and put it in this little, like, I don't know, 2.5, maybe 3 gallon pot. And quit licking my toes, dog. And it's doing way better. Way better. This whole branch started out. Basically, I mean, it had that root rot stuff going on, so I pulled it off, hosed off all the old dirt, cut off some of the black roots, and just threw it in some clean dirt, crossed my fingers, and just hoped for the best. And this is just getting rainwater, and I'm not even touching it. I'm just kind of letting it just do its own thing here. It's open to the sky, so it gets a little bit of afternoon light, not a whole much. This is some dumb seedling started out of a pit. Same thing with that guy, nothing real special. This is Blitz. If you saw our dog video where we did a dog house or something like that, named her Blitz. She's a white German Shepherd, so it's kind of short for Blitzkrieg, like German, you know, lightning warfare, I think is what it means. So, come on. And she is lightning fast too. Nice, she's a puppy, so she's a nibbler. This is a lamb hoss I bought it just for fun. It was cheap, so I grabbed that. This is a blood orange. This is a Pinkerton. So the dog kind of munched on him a little bit, but it was doing better. So I think maybe if it lives next year, we have room. Maybe I'll put it over here somewhere because they're fairly small. Oh, and this, if anybody's watching, is supposed to be a lime tree, but they look like lemons. So I don't know how. I kind of thought about this after we got it. I like limes, but I have no idea knowing when they're ready. So I don't know if this is a lime tree or if this is mistagged. It's a lemon tree. I don't know what it is. That's like navel orange. This guy back here is a Spare Fuerte. I have one of these out in the front yard. This one is just kind of, maybe I'll grow it and give it away to a friend or something. Lowe's sells these really cheap for like 20 bucks. And this is my lamb hoss. I painted the leaves and stuff, or the bark, white. And I think it kind of slows them down. It didn't really like it, but it didn't really die back. So I don't know. Honestly, if I were you, I'd just get one of these shade screens. And if you can, not paint it. I think it does a lot better. This was the surprise. Now this guy is the hoss. Like the boss, the hoss. I didn't really want to get a hoss tree, but had to argue with $20 at Lowe's when yours is dying, so. And my other one is pulled out, and it looks like it'll survive, and I can transplant. This is a reed. It's actually my second reed in this spot. The first one kind of died off, and this one's not doing a whole lot better. I think they were getting cooked in the afternoon. And, I had actually a double shades cloth here, and I just pulled that back the other day, but I think this one is going to maybe pull out of it. I'm not watering it at all. but come on, focus. It's getting little buds on there. So, anyways, it's green, and it's not dead yet, so I'm having hope. And let's see, this was my Meyer's lemon tree, which actually they're very nice lemons. If anybody wants to know what type of lemon tree to get, I don't have them all, but I do like this. They're kind of halfway between an orange and a lemon, so they're not super super sour. And if you're a fan, these are all blueberry trees, which I was going to do some kind of a taste test thing, and we just didn't really get enough blueberries, and we were on vacation a lot for the summertime, so that's where that is. And I don't even know which ones are which variety, other than they haven't moved since I made the video, because now this guy loves munching, hey, on plastic tags for some reason. Quit chewing on my plant. So some of them I've pulled out, put in here, and yeah, here we go. Like, this was my tag for Patriot, and I'm going to have to come up with some other kind of metal tag system, because I don't know what the hell they are. If I lose track of where they were, so I haven't moved anything, so I can go back to my video and figure them out. This is a holiday, and this guy is a weird, lanky little thing. Doesn't really bush out. It's like all spindly, but it's doing okay. They're supposed to be really good tasting, and they're kind of compact. So that's why I'm putting them here, is basically we have a few feet between the fence, but the sun just beats down on here really bad. And this is my other dwarf midget thing, holiday, which is, this one is supposed to be a dwarf anyways. And this is the other one that's supposed to be a dwarf, little cotto, because these are two small spots. So, what do you think, Blitz? You want avocados? Supposedly dogs are supposed to like avocados, but I don't think they're good for them. Quit eating on my plants. Hey. Hey. You eat the blueberries, not the plants. Stop it. Okay. Come on. Stop. Ugh. So, these are the blueberries. Whatever this one is, it kind of keeps its foliage a little bit. Stop eating the plant! Stop. Blitz, no. No. Leave it. We're still working on puppy training. Leave it. Leave it. Stay. Stay. Hey. I don't know why. She only eats on it when I'm here. Stop. Blitz, no. Stop. Anyways, this is our other project. We have a wood burner, so I was building these. Not totally unrelated here, but so each one of these holds about a cord and a third, maybe. So this is where the splits are. This is where my logs are. This is where the tools are going to go, which this thing's pretty cool. It's called a wood splitter XL or something. I forget anyway. It's probably on here somewhere. Well, it's the bigger version, but basically it's like a hatchet blade, and you grab the split, you put it inside, and then you just whack it with the hammer so you don't cut yourself, or it's a lot less likely anyway. What is this thing called? Oh, kindling cracker. Yeah. And this is the extra large version, which, I mean, I got a pretty big hand, so this thing is, gotta be 8 7 inches across. And this is the wood that we just now cut, and this is gonna dry up for about 2 years before we burn it. So the whole theory is, this year is gonna be a little weird, but most of these splits should stay. I'm gonna burn the logs, then next year, we're gonna put wood in here to cure and dry, and this one and this pile should be ready to go, and then that will be burned 2 years from now, and every year we'll empty one of these out and then fill it back again. So this was the year I started it all, so I had to move a shitload of wood. And this one didn't get filled up all the way, and this one didn't get filled up all the way either. I bought year-old wood on these two to get them going so we could burn something this year. Anyways, we have almond wood where we are. We're pretty lucky. And then I just have a little tool thing that I built. Ash bucket, chainsaw. Even though there's not a chainsaw in here, I just put wood splitting tools like wedges and stuff. And I'm debating about putting my axes and stuff out here on little bungee cords just to get it all out here. I don't know why we have shovels out here, but whatever. But this was built out of redwood I bought at Lowe's. They were clearancing this stuff out. Big old 2x6s of true heart redwood. You know, 12-foot 2x6s for like $4. So I bought up every single thing they had and built this. If I bought this wood, it would have cost, Jesus, I don't know, thousands of dollars. But I bought all this wood. Plus, we had enough to do the redwood fence back there. So $5,000 worth of redwood for like $500. I mean, how do you beat that? Can't even buy Doug fir for that. But the way this thing is built is the whole thing is about an inch or two off the ground sitting on the blocks. Now you don't get to lick my camera. So air gets under it, on top of it, around the backside. It totally just dries out. And that's just to keep a snoopy neighbor out. There's the wall back here. And, you know, kind of just, you know, whatever. This is a little reserve for going camping and stuff like that. This is my own creation, which I don't need in the wintertime. It has a big old brass valve in it, 1-inch valve, and you turn it on. Keeps the water from gushing out, just kind of waters gently. You can chew on the wood if you want, Blitz. Stay away from my blueberry plants. That is my little startups of rosemary, because bees are supposed to like rosemary for pollinating. So, quick walk of the garden here. I have some boysenberries, blueberries, blackberries back there, but I don't know, they're kind of a pain in the butt. I thought you trellised them once and you're done. I didn't know you had to deal with cutting them down and re-trellising them every single year, so I think they're going to die and I'm going to do something else. I just never get around to doing it. There's the mother plant here for rosemary. And from the other side, Myers tree, Fuerte, navel orange, I think. Yeah, navel orange. This is the lime tree. Stop chewing on the trees. What? No. That's my Pinkerton. The blood orange here. And yeah, lamb hoss. And the latter was for getting up and cleaning up my gutters, which I do it once at the beginning, then wait for all the leaves to fall, then I get up and do it again when it's all done. And here is my little surprise. So I'm kind of happy to see that make it back. If anybody says that once they start dying, they're lost causes, I think there might be some salvation. Wash the dirt off and swish it around real well, put it in clean dirt and kind of cross your fingers. I think this guy will bounce back. I'm not going to leave it outside this year. There's no way in hell that little thing can take any kind of frost. So this one's portable, so I can bring it in and out. So we left it in there, even with a heat lamp or whatever, done. So anyways, a bit of a spoiler. I wanted to show this the way it was. I did this in the summertime and just never made a video about it. And it did hold off the heat. If anybody's going to do this, we have these 100 degree days for days on end, and these things were, I thought they were all gonna die. But right now during the fall, I don't water them, I don't touch them. We got a lot of rain, the humidity is, they're loving it right now. We get night times in the upper 40s, lower 50s, rain every, I don't know, 3-4 days, so it keeps it humid. And they're blossoming and they're budding and they're having a hell of a time, like right here. So they're starting to come back. Even that reed that's over there that I just figured I'm gonna leave it in the ground anyways. Maybe it'll spring back, maybe not, who knows, but it doesn't cost me anything to leave it in the ground for this year. So, anyways, that's pretty much it. And then I'm going to run electrical on here with wires along the fence and wrap these in plastic. And hopefully for this year, maybe the year after, you know, keep them away from the freeze, and then they should hopefully be hardy enough to do it by themselves, or survive by themselves. But boy, I gotta tell you, I didn't know we were getting a dog, so it's like a whole nother level of work with the wire cages and the whatever. If anybody is doing this in California, Central Valley, it's a real pain in the butt. I don't think I'd do it, honestly, if I knew what was going to be in store for me with this. But since I'm in it, I'm invested. I've bought them, I've built the cages, so I got to see it through at this point. I'm not going to just take a total loss and then try and figure out what I'm going to put in these planter boxes. So I'm in it. Follow this for a few years if you're interested. So the next video I'm going to make, I'm going to grab Austin. We're going to wrap these up in plastic and put them on a timer. So they have a incandescent light that pops on at like, I don't know. I'll have to figure it out. Coldest part of the night, maybe 4 in the morning or something like that. Just to beat back the frost. And I'm going to go out and show you the front yard. So these are all the same plants that were in here. Different reed, and we swapped a surprise to a hoss. Everything else is the same back here. And something's going here. Either the surprise is going to go here or the Pinkerton's going to go here next year. You know, haven't made up my mind. Have to see how that does. And I'm going out front here. Okay, and these are the avocados in the front yard. Mostly the same thing we have going on. I don't know if I had a shade screen out here before, but this is basically like the things in the front. But this is obviously on the western side to kind of keep that afternoon sun from scorching the thing. And this is the Fuerte, which, yeah, it's probably doing the best out of all of them. This was the hardiest when it went in, and it's kind of, you know, up and down and back and forth. But with fall, put a whole bunch of the leaves in here to start decomposing. But now we're just finally starting to cool down, so all these little buds and stuff are popping up. But I don't know about this. I put this stuff on, and maybe I didn't dilute it down enough, but wherever I painted these things, it's like I glued the leaflets shut, and they don't want to push through it. So, I don't know. Kind of back and forth on that. Shade screen's not going to hurt it, but that white paint, I don't know, I got it at Lowe's. I think it was like Valspar, so maybe it's just toxic to them or something, but the ones I painted did not seem to do well. This spot had, I think, a Stewart, and this is a problem where we are. The sprinklers come on, and they were just blasting the hell out of this, and they were drowning it. So that's the reason for this, is just basically to keep the sprinklers from shooting all over it. But it still puddles and it gets water under here, so it's still not exactly good for it. But the Stewart died, so this is now a Jim Bacon. So it's having a rough time too. It looked great when I put it in. But same thing, the water just overwatered it. All the leaves have fallen off. Cut it, died back a little bit. So it's kind of, it's like that reed in the backyard. It's still hanging in there, but it's not looking great. But, you know, since we're heading into that time of year where we don't have to water them, on rainwater it does okay. And this is my Mexicola that... it was a Mexicola Grande. Now, that one died. You know, I don't really know what happened. The wind was too wicked, so now I put this in as a windbreak, tied it off, and that's just a regular old Mexicola, and it's doing pretty good. So, that's an update of the yard. Okay, guys, I'm just going to do a combo video here. This is now winter time, just after Christmas. We might be into January. It's a Sunday. I'm not sure what the day it is. So anyways, late December, January, and these are my avocados wrapped up in plastic. Austin helped me, and we just barely got this done before the first day kind of came in, and I think the night we did it, it got to be 36 degrees, so it was not freezing point, but it was pretty damn cold, and this wound up being a little bit more work than what I was planning on doing, but anyways, this is obviously the plastic wrap to keep them from freezing, and I'll just do a quick little walk, avoiding landmines here on the ground. I've got Blitz inside right about now, so we don't have that issue going on. But this is just like 3 mil. I would like to have clear, but they only had white. And basically, this is the Lamb Haas one. And I threw some wood ashes in here. We've got the burner going, so that's what the white stuff is. And this is just when I trimmed off the evergreen things. But it's got an incandescent bulb. Has to be incandescent because those are the ones that actually make the heat. LED CFL don't work, so these just run on a timer. I just bought some cheap stuff at Walmart, basic little fixture, and I just kind of hung it off of a string, and I put a tarp up there with a little gutter piece or broomstick or something, whatever I could find. It has just a little slit to kind of let the heat out so I don't cook the plant. And this is all loose and floppy down here, so there's plenty of air to come up through the bottom. But I'm worried about landmines here. And that's pretty much where they're at. They're not really growing. They're not really doing much. Hopefully this is just kind of a stay alive kind of thing. That one is the Haas. But I just got a bunch of 50-foot extension cords, outdoor rated or something. And then I've got my little shed. Well, anyways, I'm not even gonna bother opening it up. I kinda got it padlocked so the dog doesn't get in there, but basically they're just on a little timer that kicks on at, I think I have it kicking on at midnight, you know, when it starts to get chilly, and then they run all the way until 8 o'clock the next morning when the sun is basically coming up, and then they shut down so I don't wind up cooking the plants. And I thought about trying to just unplug it and plug it in when it was freezing and that kind of thing, and, you know, do all that. But if I forget one time, I'm gonna wind up cooking them. And with these plastic wraps, I was gonna open them and then close them every day, but that's kind of, it's honestly just a real pain in the ass. So I just cut a hole, they vent a little bit, and I'm just gonna let the lights supply the light to the plant, kind of like a little greenhouse grow light kind of thing. And this is the reed that may or may not make it. Okay, well anyway, something happened there. I think I actually hit the button off, but this is the reed. Why am I on landscape? I don't want to be on landscape. I don't know, I'm just going to roll. So that's the reed. We got the dog digging all over the place. And just wood ashes on everything else over here. Avocados, blueberries. This dog loves pulling out my sticks. So I've totally lost track of what's what other than my YouTube video. So I'm gonna buy some metal stakes or something because the dog is a thing for plastic. And here is the holiday. And the last one is the little cotto. And pretty much everything has the same setup. Oh, there's the monster right there. Hey, Blitz. Yeah, she doesn't like being outside when I'm out here. And I think somebody was asking about our little wood pile thingy here. This I just built. This is, I don't know, we did this about a month ago, so I'm trying not to use too many of the splits, and we're using mostly the logs. So there we are. And that thing was called a kindling cracker. So that's pretty much it. Well, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, all that kind of stuff. Oh, there's my little broomsticks. I just have those laying across the top so the water kind of sheets off like a little teepee. And that's pretty much it. Bye, guys.